This is a big question. This is one of the biggest questions that we tackle in my course. And you're right, Joachim, it's not a direct answer, just like everything in UX, right? There's always a lot of inputs to consider. A couple things that I would suggest, look at the way your organization is structured. One thing you want to figure out early on is there a CX team? Is there a traditional CX team that already exists that maybe has that brand perception marketing focus? Where are they aligned in the organization? Where do they report in the structure? Think about where your UX and design resources are situated. Ideally, if there is a centralized design organization, that's good because that means there's something that you can build upon. If your design and UX people are decentralized and they're aligned to different product teams, we don't really have that central team that we can kind of grow upon. So those are a couple places where you might add these resources: traditional CX team, a design org if it exists and is centralized. Maybe you don't have either of those and you need to kind of establish something brand new somewhere. Either way, it is a big benefit to have these resources aligned as high up in your organizational hierarchy as possible. So that's kind of the benefit that CX teams often have, is that they're usually reporting up to the chief experience officer or somebody in marketing that's high up. So that gives them a really nice vantage point. They have a line of sight into every underlying functional group that they need to facilitate collaboration for this work. Whereas a lot of times design is maybe situated down on the product organization or maybe within technology. So they're lower in the structure. They don't have the overarching influence or line of sight or executive support that CX does. So wherever you put it, think about where you have the opportunity to place it based on how you're structured now, and also try to find executive support and situate yourself as high up as possible.